Hello and welcome to another video. I've been creating videos about Linux commands and setup that are useful for system admins, but recently I received some feedbacks which suggested me that I should also create some videos for those who want to learn Linux system but have never used it before. So going forward, I'll be creating series of videos targeting for those who have never used Linux before but want to try it out and learn its powerful command line tool. So I'll start the series with the fresh installation of Linux system and follow up with other tools and commands in future videos. I'll also create a playlist on my YouTube channel for new Linux users where I would put all the videos that new users would find helpful. If you have never installed Linux system or never used it, then I encourage you to try installing it as a virtual machine first. You can use either VMware Workstation Player or VirtualBox as your Type 2 hypervisor. So Type 2 hypervisor will need a host operating system, either Windows, Linux, or Mac, where it gets installed, and then create an environment for a guest operating system, which will be the Linux in our case. VMware Workstation has both free and paid version, but only allows you to run one VM at one time in free version. But if you use VirtualBox, which is developed by Oracle, you can run as many VMs as you want, given that your system resources allow you to run them at one time. So I'm guessing that majority of my viewers will be looking to set up home labs. And in that case, I highly recommend using VirtualBox. So let's go ahead and download VirtualBox and install it. I already have it installed on my computer. So this is a VirtualBox. And I already have a few VMs installed. After you download the VirtualBox, it shouldn't take more than a couple of minutes to install it. It's really lightweight. And after you install, this is the interface of the program. So you will not have all these virtual machines. You'll have empty panel. So our next step after downloading and installing VirtualBox would be actually downloading the Linux system you want to use. In this video, I'm going to show you the process by installing latest Ubuntu Desktop as a virtual machine inside VirtualBox. So let's go ahead and download from Ubuntu website. So ubuntu.com, get Ubuntu, and then we're going to download Ubuntu Desktop. And this is the latest long-term support Ubuntu Desktop 20.04. So we're gonna hit download. I have already downloaded before I started recording the video so that I won't be wasting any time. And also I created a video on this channel. I believe it was a second video, but I'll put a link on the top right corner so that you can go ahead and check it out. In that video, I talked about some pre-install and post-install tasks, which I recommend you to do any Linux system you're going to install and use. So after download, it will take you to the page where you can verify your download. So if you click verify download, it'll ask you to run this command. So basically it is asking you to check the integrity of the file by performing that checksum using SHA-256 algorithm. So this command is for Linux user, but since we have a Windows, we are going to do that in a Windows command line. And the command for Windows is cert util -has file, then you are going to locate the file that we just downloaded in Ubuntu. And at the end, you do SHA-256 because that's an algorithm. It'll take a few seconds. And it should produce the has file that was provided by Ubuntu, which is this. And if it matches, then we know that our download was not corrupted. This is one of the pre-install steps that you would perform when you download and install any software, provided that your software company has given you the has file. So it looks like it's a match. I start with 93BDA, 93BDA, and then end with 89E5, 85. Even if there's a slight change on the file that you downloaded, your has will be completely different. So now you know that your download is good and not corrupted. So we can exit out of the command prompt and we can close this one. Now let's open the VirtualBox. And if you want to install it on a bare metal as a single boot or dual boot system instead of virtual machine, you can burn the ISO image that we just downloaded into a DVD if your computer has a DVD ROM. Or if your computer supports booting from USB drive, you can create a bootable flash drive using software of your choice. There are many options available, but I have used this software called Etcher, which you can download from here, bolina.io. And you can use this program to create a bootable flash drive using the ISO that we just downloaded. So just open the program and insert the flash drive that you want to flash with, you want to make bootable. So I just inserted a USB drive and just click flash from file. So here you'll give the location of the file, ISO file that we just downloaded. So this is the file that we just downloaded and select the target. So target would be USB drive, select, and then click flash. So this will use the ISO image that we just downloaded and create a bootable flash drive. So we're gonna go ahead and minimize this one. One thing you have to be careful is if you're installing it as a dual boot system alongside Windows, just make sure that you have enough unallocated space to install your Linux system. You can actually open the disk utility, diskngnt.msc opens up a disk management utility where you can manage your Windows partition. So if you do not have extra partition to install Linux, you can actually right click on the existing partition, shrink the volume. When you hit shrink volume, it will analyze the space and try to create unallocated space that you can use for Linux system. And after you have created that space, you can close it out. And next step would be setting up a BIOS to boot from USB. Depending on different computer models, you might have to press different key to go to BIOS, but usually F2 works in most of the computer. And when you are in the BIOS, just make sure that your BIOS is set to boot from USB and then plug your USB device, which we just flashed using Etcher, and restart the computer. The installation process after that would be similar with what we are going to do now in VirtualBox. So flash is complete. I can now close it out and your USB is ready. You can go to the BIOS now, change the boot sequence and restart the computer. On VirtualBox, we're gonna hit create new and name will be Ubuntu 20.04, for example. So it automatically detected that I'm installing Ubuntu. And next, so this is the path of your virtual disk file and the memory, you can drag the slider or you can simply type, let's say for 4 GB and create a virtual hard disk now. The recommended size is 10 GB, create. So default is fine, VDI, and dynamically allocated so that it will grow. It does not take a whole 10 GB at the same time. Next, so you can define a size here, size of the hard disk. So 10 GB was recommended, but I think 10 GB will not be enough because if you're installing graphics, you might need more. So let's go ahead and do 20 GB, create. So after we hit create, it will create a space. So this created environment for Ubuntu 20.4. And there are some settings that I want you to change. So if you click on settings by selecting this one, go to settings, go to advanced. So your shared clipboard, you can enable it bidirectional so that your Windows and guest operating system, which is Ubuntu, can actually perform bidirectional drag and drop. And rest, you can leave it as a default. Go to system. And memories here, processor, if you have multiple processors, try increasing that. And we are going to set up the boot sequence. So this is same as we do in the BIOS. So right now we don't use floppy. So optical will be the first one. And let's do hard disk second. And the next step would be mounting the optical drive. So display, let's do graphical 128 to support Ubuntu desktop. So our next step would be mounting the ISO image to the CD drive. And Ubuntu and choose. This one we can remove. So now we mounted the ISO image as a CD drive and we have set optical drive as a first boot. So when we start the virtual machine, it will read from the optical disk, which is ISO image. And network, you can leave default NAT. And that's it. So click OK. And now when we start, the installation process would be similar with what we're going to do now, either in a virtual box or the dual boot system. In a virtual environment, you can choose auto partition since the disk you would be selecting is just a block of space inside your Windows drive. But when you're installing on a bare metal, especially if you're going to install as a dual boot system alongside with Windows, you have to be careful with the partition step. I recommend you to perform manual partition instead of auto partitioning the disk. So now You can try Ubuntu without installing it. What happens is when you reboot, it's not persistent. So any file or directory you create will be loaded on the memory, but when you reboot, it will be gone. So you can actually try Ubuntu before installing it. But since we're installing it, go ahead and click install Ubuntu, continue. So here it's asking what apps would you like to install to start with? So you can go with a normal installation and it will give you web browser, utilities, office programs, and some games. But I'm gonna go with the minimal installation so that it won't take a lot of time. And later you can always select the apps that you need. Other option, download updates while installing Ubuntu. You can select this option, but just to save time for this video, I'm gonna uncheck it. And you can check other options as well. So continue. So it is saying this computer currently has no detected operating system. What do you like to use? Because this is a whole space, 20 gigabyte that we allocated as a virtual disk. It couldn't find any operating system. So it's asking, what do you wanna do? So this is something that I want you to be careful. So do something else because we are now going to create a partition ourselves. And I wanna do this because it will also cover for the users who want to install Linux as a dual boot system on the bare metal. So continue. And now this is the hard drive that it presented. You might have another one, SDB or SDC, depending on the hard drive. So new partition table. So it's just giving you warning that you have selected an entire device for the partition. Continue. And we are going to create a new partition here. First partition that we are going to create is a swap. So for swap, let's do 4 gigabyte. And use as a swap area. Okay. So it created a swap partition. Now I'm going to create a boot partition, which should not take more than, let's say, 500 MB. So EXT4 file system is fine, default, and boot partition. Okay. Now we have 16 gigabyte left, and we can use all 16 gigabyte for the root partition, or you can separate for different mount points. For example, you can create a separate partition for home drive, but I'm gonna go ahead and use everything for the root. So click okay. And now when you click install now, it will create this partition table and format the drive. And this is the drive that we created from VirtualBox. Install now. So it's giving me a message that it's going to be formatted using swap and EXT4 file system. So continue. This is why it's safe to use as a VirtualBox, because even if you mess up something, it'll just work on that 20 gigabyte that you created as a virtual disk. So if you're using dual boot system, it might mess up your other side of Windows if something goes wrong. That's why I recommend using VirtualBox. But if you're experienced and you wanna use bare metal, just be careful and create a manual partition. So New York's fine. And now you are going to create a user and you can give a name, whatever name you want. Username, and then pick your password. So login automatically or require my password. So I'm gonna click require. And this user that you create will be the sudo user, so admin user. And you can use that user to perform other installation. Because by default, root is disabled on the latest Linux distributions, including Ubuntu. Red Hat still gives you option to install, to create a root user, but Ubuntu and other latest distribution, they discourage you to have a root user. But if you want, you can go ahead and log in as the user that you just created and then use command sudo space su hyphen, then it will let you to the root user and you can use passwd command to change the password. We'll talk about that later, but let's finish the installation first. It's almost done now. The installation is complete now and we need to restart. So go ahead and click restart now. So after the installation is finished, it's asking us to remove the installation media. If you're using USB drive or DVD-ROM, just eject that and press enter. In my case, in VirtualBox, I didn't do anything, just press enter. And now it booted up with the system that we just installed. And log in with the password that we created during the installation process. And if you're using VirtualBox on Windows environment, you can actually press Control Home, which gives you menu, and you can go in full screen mode. So skip, next, that's fine. And privacy location is off, so we're done. So if I right click and go to display settings, I can select the resolution, do this one, apply, keep changes. Now here you can change your appearance, color, dark, what kind of theme you want, and other stuff like display and privacy. And so you can go around and play with it. But for now, I'm gonna show you one more thing. So this is the Ubuntu software. That's an installation or package manager. It's actually a snap store, which we'll talk about detail in future videos. But you can actually open this software, which will be on your sidebar, Ubuntu software, and search and install any software that you need. Let's say, for example, if you want a video player, then VLC is very popular, and you can search for VLC player and install it. Set up a display on different resolution. I'm not seeing the bottom part. Let's do this one. So now here you have Solve Application button. You can click there and go to Software Update. So it'll actually install any update using graphical tools. You can install now, or if you want to use command line, you can do so by using, let me show you. So when your Ubuntu software is open, you can actually search for the program that you want to install, or if it's already here, you can select it. So go ahead and search a VLC here. And select. And click install. We're installing. And you can go here and launch the software updater or terminal from here. And once it's open, you can actually right click and add to your favorite. So it will stay on the sidebar. And you can actually do sudo apt. Get update. It will update the repository for your Ubuntu system. So it will actually perform the check and update all the repository for any application. Then you can perform sudo apt get upgrade to actually upgrade your system using command line. So if you click no here, let's say, and do hyphen y, it will automatically click yes on that question. So you can use this option, or you can go to let me change the display setting. I'm not sure what happened here. So you could use a command line tool, or you could go here and launch the software updater. Now it will try to update your system, which is very crucial to keep your system up to date. And this is it for today's video. So I hope I gave you some guideline on how to install as a virtual machine using VirtualBox, and also gave you some guide on how to install as a bare metal. So in the future videos, I'll be covering basic commands and tools for new Linux user. Thanks for being with me on this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.